Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will show you another more reliable way to install VirtualBox. If you are wondering why on earth did I show you the other way using the RPM, if we're not going to use it here, well, it's always good to have another option. Plus, the procedure is exactly the same if you're installing any other RPM package. So you just type in RPM-I and then you just type in the name of the package that you have downloaded and that you wish to install. The procedure is exactly the same. I would recommend passing an H argument as well to give you a status bar, because if you just go ahead and type it in like this with the name of the package, it's going to install it no problems, of course, but the screen is just going to wait. Nothing is going to happen. You might think it's bugged or something like that during the installation procedure. Like this with H, there's a status bar that shows, so you know that something in the background is happening. But as I said, it's good to have another option. What we want to do today and now is actually install VirtualBox using the default packet manager called yum and pull the package from the repositories. Now, what are repositories? Repositories are places where software packages are stored for Linux distros, and then you can pull those packets, those software packets, from your Linux distro using the default packet manager. It's very simple, it's extremely easy, and it's one of those things that you will absolutely need to know how to do, because you'll be installing and uninstalling a lot of things during the course of your pen testing career, during the course of pretty much any pen testing exercise in general. So let me just demonstrate this to you. You type in yum and then you give it a command. First of all, you use yum to call your default packet manager, which is yum basically because I'm using Fedora, but if I was using some sort of a Debian distro, it could be aptitude, or it could be apt-get, and some other distros have their own packet managers, but we're not going to get into those now. Later on, I will show you what Kali Linux is using. That is the Linux distro that we will be using in order to conduct some of the pen testing exercises. So first off, you type in yum, as I said, and then type in search, which is you're basically telling yum what to do. You want it to search for something, so you just type in search. It's pretty much exactly the same as English language. You just kind of need to figure out the logic of it. And then you want to search for an approximate name of the package that you want. So perhaps you don't know the full name or something like that. Don't worry about it. Just type in a portion of the name. It will suffice. And pretty much everything that contains that portion of the name will be displayed. So we know what we want. It's VirtualBox, and you might think that this is the full name of the package, but no, it is not. Soon you will see. And there you go. It has printed out every package that contains VirtualBox in its name, the word VirtualBox in the name of the package or in the description of the package, because you see you have the name of the package here, colon, and then you have the description of the package here. There are a lot of things have popped with the name VirtualBox, and you're wondering perhaps which one to install. Well, you need the kmod one, and here you have the kernel version and the Fedora version. So FC would be the Fedora version, and here you have the architecture. It's 64. I can't select it. There we go. It's 64, and here you have the kernel version. So you can compare it to what you have, and based on what you have, what your operating system is, you can pick it from here, assuming that it's a Fedora 20. You can use any other distro. The procedure is fairly the same. Later on in the question parts, if you're using, for example, a Debian-based distro or a OpenSUSE or something like that, feel free to ask me. If you can't manage it there, I will help you out, no problems. But for the time being, I'm just going to go ahead and install it here. Let me just go ahead and clear the screen. In order to install the package, you need to type yum install, and then you need to go ahead and type the name of your package, which would be the last one for me anyway. this one. Oops, here we go. The name is a bit long, so I'm just going to go ahead and copy it. But you see, there is one fundamental problem here. The VirtualBox package is not found in the default repositories of Fedora. And that is a bit of a problem, primarily because none of these commands would actually work if I did not previously import RPM Fusion repositories. RPM Fusion is simply the name for a certain type of repositories containing certain types of packets. So I have imported those repositories, and now I can pull information and packages from them. If I did not do that previously, I would not have been able to do any of these things. Yum search VirtualBox would yield no results of whatsoever. I would get a blank screen. I would get like a message here saying that no packages were found that matched this particular name, and then just a blank screen. That's it. So that can be problematic. In order to solve that problem, you need to go ahead and open up your favorite browser. I already have this website opened to save a bit of time. It says rpmfusion.org slash configuration, but here let me just go ahead and search for it. So type into any search engine RPM Fusion, it's gonna pop, do not worry. So it's rpmfusion.org. Click on the website, open it up, and here you're gonna get instructions immediately. It's a very simplistic website. There isn't any tinkering that you need to think about or some advanced configuration, nothing of a kind. It just says for users and says enable RPM Fusion on your system. Click OK. Not OK, just click on the link and there you go. You get a listing here, you get a listing of downloads. It says free and non-free. And don't be intimidated with this non-free. You do not need to pay for anything. It is non-free for redistributable software that is not open source software as defined by Fedora licensing guidelines. So this non-free does not refer to money. You do not need to pay anything here. I cannot make that any clearer. It simply refers that the software is not open source software as defined by Fedora licensing guidelines. So it might actually be open source, but it just doesn't fit within the boundaries of Fedora licensing guidelines. Anyway, that part is not that interesting to you. Down below, the thing that you need to know here is that non-free is actually free in terms of money, but non-free in terms of source code. Anyway, as I said, that's not really that important for you anyway at the moment. Down here, you have actually RPM packages. Remember from the previous tutorial, I've showed you the extension .rpm. When you download a package, we could actually download one of these. Actually, I would download the first one and then install it using my RPM software. Just type in RPM space dash I, and then I would, there we go, I just clicked on it. Then I would pass this file name as an argument as well, and it would install it no problems as well. But I don't really want to do that at the moment. I want to show you a different way of doing it. If you're wondering why it is being repeated twice, this is for free and this is for non-free. Excellent. What we want is the command line setup using RPM. It says here Fedora 14 to the most current, so mine is 20. It's going to work there no problems as well. So you have this very long command, and you don't really need to know what every single portion of this command is or what it does. Sum total, it imports a repository into your system that you are going to use later on. They have given this command so you can do it from one tap. Basically, you don't need to go about doing things or anything of a kind. You basically just copy, paste this, and run it. You are using your default package manager. You're using local install option. You are not checking for certain types of keys. You are you're giving it the place from which to pull it, and so on and so forth. But later on, as we progress through this tutorial, we will deal extensively with Linux command line. So only then will these things become clearer to you. Once I actually explain some of the basic and fundamental things, then you will be able to understand things such as those listed in this bracket. Sorry, not bracket, within the confines of this parentheses, and so on. Because if I started explaining it now, it would make no sense, and it would simply complicate things further. As I said, later on, when we get into the command line interface of Linux, when I start explaining it in great detail, there I will begin from scratch and move you basically from beginner to advanced user in a relatively short amount of time, and then you will be able to understand what all of these things are. For the time being, just copy this content, which is within the confines of these quotation marks, and paste it into your terminal. So you do need to be root. Let me just go ahead and exit. I am no longer root, as you can see. I am now my regular user, chronic. Just type in su, type in your password, and paste this. Press enter. Okay, obviously it won't install here because I already have it installed. Yeah, it says nothing to do of whatsoever. But on your system where you do not have RPM Fusion installed, this would just fly as well. This would just pass, no problems, and you would successfully have installed RPM Fusion on your system as well. So clear. Anyway, I just wanted to show you something else that I neglected to show you a moment ago. This command that we've ran, it actually installs free and non-free repositories. If you just take a closer look to what I am highlighting at the moment, this is the free, so it says http download 1.rpmfusion.org/free/fedora/rpmfusion free release. And down below you have the second address, again download rpmfusion.org, and it says non-free. So I'm highlighting the entire thing here. Let me just zoom it in a bit more so everybody can see. And there you go. You have two completely, well, they're not completely different addresses, but they are definitely different addresses referring to different types of repositories. Anyway, now you can go back to your terminal. Do not log out of root. Stay root, because you will need root privileges in order to do this. Type in yum search once again, VirtualBox, press enter, take the last one or whatever one suits your current kernel. You check the current kernel by typing in uname-a, and here you go. So it's 3.18.7.100, 3.18.7.100, FC20, FC20, and then you have the architecture listed here as well. So clear the screen, type in yum install, paste the name of the package, press space dash y, and if you have this command, just press enter and it will install, it will run through. I have already installed VirtualBox to save some time as well. You will have it up and running on your system, and after you've installed it, do not forget to type in yum update as well. So let the system just run through the updates, so you would make sure that you have the latest version, that you have everything up to date and running. In any case, that would be it for this tutorial. In the next one, I will start VirtualBox up, explaining some of its features, and hopefully through the follow-up tutorials I will start installing an operating system within my virtual machine, within my virtual environment, and we'll see how that process goes. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.